Hi everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I'm Damian, and today I'm joined by Gopi. Gopi, what are we talking about?
Today I'll just show you how do you use GitHub Actions for deploying to Azure.
Very cool. GitHub Actions to Azure, don't miss it. Hi everyone, welcome back to the DevOps Lab. I am Damian, and today I am joined by Gopi, who is a program manager on the Azure Pipelines team, right?
Yes.
We were talking about this before, and this is something that may not be familiar to most people, but Azure Pipelines, the Azure Pipelines team, is responsible not just for the Azure Pipelines product, but for any kind of CI/CD into Azure, right?
Right, yes.
Which includes things like GitHub Actions.
Exactly, yes.
So we were talking about this, and you were saying, oh yeah, we do that. That's part of what we're working on. And I'd love to talk a little bit more about GitHub Actions and getting that into Azure and how that can work.
Yep, okay. So GitHub Actions is currently in private preview. As you can see, I just have a repo that is available. Mm-hmm. Now in this repo, I can just configure actions to do pretty much any activity. I'm just switched from my code to actions repo. There is already one action that is configured, but uh-huh. I'll now just get into edit view and then just show you all the capabilities of it. So
GitHub Actions is ultimately just a pipeline of things that you can run when stuff happens in GitHub. Is that
yes.
a good summary?
It's like a workflow.
Okay.
Any event, as you can just see here, it can be there is something that is created, there is a commit comment that is added, or there is a PR that is done, or there is a push that is done. There are many use cases. You want to get a pull request comment, mm-hmm. then you want to get an email.
Yeah.
Right? Automatic email or maybe SMS message. Or if a push happens into, the master or any of those repos, actually want to trigger build and test and then the deploy. Or they have actually available for even the issues too. If the issue status changes or if issue commits, you can just pretty much write any workflow that is relevant to the developers using the GitHub Actions.
So it's definitely a little bit more than CI/CD. CI/CD is something that you can definitely do with it, but
right.
it does.
It can do pretty much everything.
Okay, cool.
And the interesting thing is, every of the action that actually, creates can be run in a container image.
Right.
And then they do have extensibility available where you can, keep adding actions. Mm-hmm. I think that's the capability that we actually took advantage of adding Azure deployment actions to GitHub.
Right. So that's what your team has done, is they've added Azure deployment actions to GitHub Actions.
To the GitHub Actions,
perfect.
Yes. So, here is where, I have one, a workflow that is defined. You can see they have a visual editor that's available, mm-hmm. Where you can just, edit the workflow and then keep it growing. They also have the file. Right?
Okay.
And this is a kind of YAML syntax that they follow. You can see it's always sitting in the .github directory. In the .github directory, you create main.workflow or your application.workflow, and mm-hmm. you can define the actions.
Okay.
And it's very simple. The main workflow says, tell me which is the last action that needs to be executed. Like deploy app, if you see deploy app is the last action, then every action will say deploy action needs create web app for container, and then create web app container needs Azure login.
Excuse me. Sorry.
You will keep just building it up.
Yeah.
Now, one thing that we can do, I'm just now going to show you a set of actions, that we have built. I'll first go to the last one. If I have to add an action, I just need to drag and drop.
Oh, that's cool.
Now, as soon as you just drag and drop, you can see it just pops up this window with all the featured actions that are available. And some of these featured actions are actually built by GitHub first. Mm-hmm. The Azure ones are actually built by us. You can see, GitHub Actions for AWS, for Google Cloud, and GitHub Actions for Azure.
Right, cool.
And these are featured. There are a lot more than featured actions that are available. What I will do is, I'll just pick up one of these and then just show you. Now, as soon as I add this specific action, it mm-hmm. asks me what parameters that need to be done, right?
Okay.
Because I added this is equivalent to the AG CLI action, then, what arguments that you want to run,
mm-hmm.
and assume if I'm doing AG login, if it requires any of the secrets, you can actually just mention these secrets. And then these secrets are not shown to the user.
Okay.
If you see the file,
yep.
the secrets are not visible in the YAML file at all. They're all actually stored in the config database in a secured manner inside GitHub.
Okay, right. We might have a look at where they live later, but
right. Yeah.
So this is essentially. Can you think of it as a wrapper around the AZ
CLI? This is actually a wrapper around AZ CLI.
Okay.
But now the interesting thing is, you know, we do have actually source. You can actually see what does this action do. The wow. source and actions. And we actually just open source all of those available in the public Azure, under Azure organization, mm-hmm. the GitHub Actions repo is available. Each of the action, like for example, this is a CLI action, mm-hmm. which tells you its usage, what's the action, what's the environment variables, and you know how do you execute it. And it tells you, you know, what variable values that need to be set.
Yep.
If I just go up one more level, you will actually just find all the actions that are available.
Right. These are the Azure-related ones, right?
These are all the Azure-related. The first one is the AKS deployment.
Yep.
The next one is, you know, how do I create ARM? This is, you know, you have an ARM file that's available. Mm-hmm. You want to provision resources in Azure. You can actually use it to provision ARM. Right. There is a functions for serverless guys, you know, functions is available. Container yep. web app, I think that's the one that I'll just show you. Mm-hmm. We also have, you know, pipelines. And if somebody wants to, you know, using Azure pipelines, but on a specific action, you want to invoke Azure pipelines, you can invoke Azure pipelines
right.
action too.
That's
so
cool.
Completely open source, they are available. If you do say, hey, you know, I want to add support for SQL DB, or I want to add support for IoT, mm-hmm. you know, you can submit those. Pull request
so
as
well.
So
you're accepting PRs?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Right. So that's where it is. Now, I'll just go back to this. Let me just close. I'll show you what we have built. So this action, if you see, the first three steps is, this is about login registry. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, because I'm building a Docker application, I want to log in into a Docker hub
yep.
and build the container image, tag the container image, mm-hmm. and then push the container image into the registry. Now after this, so essentially now my container image is available. The next set of steps are all about how do I take that application and then deploy it.
Okay.
So the first one is about Azure login, right? Anytime you want to, you know, do anything inside the Azure, you will actually use the Azure login command.
Yeah.
And it requires, you know, app ID, password, tenant. You can use the service principal, you know, PowerShell scripts to create these values
yeah.
and then store them as secrets.
Okay.
The next one is about, what the scenario that I'm just trying to do it is, can on every push to a GitHub, mm-hmm. can I automatically build the image? Can I automatically create a new resource? Can I deploy to that new resource and then send it for testing?
Right.
So that's the scenario we're trying to build. So as part of that, so once it logs in, now it creates a new web app for container resource. Then it has to take the key parameters that are needed in addition to that, which resource group I need to create, where is the ARM template location, and what is the ARM parameter file. These are editable because these are all environment variables. You'll yeah. be able to see those. Whereas the secrets, you won't see edit.
Oh, button. I see. Okay. Those secrets, they get set as environment variables when the task is running, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
They said as environment, but you know, they are, you know, as soon as it is done, they're completely in memory. They're never logged to any of the logs in the window.
And can I just check as well? So these are all of these tasks running in that same container that has
for each of these, for example, you know, if I just go back to this, each of these I can use a different container image.
Okay.
Let me just show you. Like, you know, this is the AKS one. If you see the Docker file, it actually just tells you they're from Microsoft Azure CLI. Right?
Yep.
Whereas if I just go back to maybe, let me pick up pipelines or release pipelines. If I see that Docker file, you will see it is from Microsoft VSDS. Yeah. So each can use its own container image based on the tool set that is needed for you.
Okay. So that would mean that each task or each individual
action
it is, each individual action is running in a different container, like a new instance of a container.
New right? instance of container. Image.
Okay, all right.
So that's why GitHub Actions is just a workflow management. You
okay.
create this workflows and you know, you manage those.
Perfect.
So these are the, you know, where, you know, which file that I want to just use for provisioning,
mm-hmm.
and then the last one is the deploy, right? So now if my resource is provisioned, tell me the app name. Now tell me, you know, where exactly the container image is present with the username and then the secret it'll just use.
Yep.
And it'll deploy it.
Wow. So this is just essentially it's a CI pipeline, right? With the CI/CD pipeline in this case.
In this particular case, it is a CI/CD pipeline, but yes.
Yeah.
Like, because, you know, we're just doing it on push, but you can pretty much do, you know, anything that you want. On push, you want to send an email, you can send an email.
So this could be pretty handy for things like PRs. So if there's a new pull request that gets submitted, spin it up in a container, deploy it, spin it up in a container, run some sanity checks, and then tear it down, maybe.
Yep, exactly.
Right. So one of the things that I wanted to drill into was the secrets, the secret data that doesn't get shown to the user when they're setting this up.
Yep.
How do you store them? Like, where do they live?
So they have a, you know, secure storage inside the GitHub. All the secrets that are marked here actually will be stored in the secure store.
Okay. So how would I add one? Is there a UI in?
Yeah, I just need to click on create secret.
Oh, okay.
That's it. You create a secret key value while adding, and whoever is the person who is adding, he will be able to see it because he has access to it.
Gotcha.
But once it is added, it's not visible.
Okay. Oh, that's very straightforward.
Yep.
I thought you were going to go somewhere else and
nope.
Show me another UI.
It's all right in line. Okay. Simple experience.
Right. That's fantastic. So. Do you know GitHub Actions is basically publicly available now? Is that right?
GitHub Actions is currently in private preview, but anybody can sign up for it.
Okay.
People can just sign up for it.
This is that time of recording too. So when we release this, maybe it'll be a different story. But,
right. Yep.
Okay. Very cool. If I wanted to go ahead and write a new Azure, not new Azure, but a new GitHub Action. Are they difficult to do? I mean, they look fairly straightforward.
Yeah, I think for every action, you actually need to write a Docker file.
Okay.
And the Docker file will contain, you know, where the image I'm just fetching from. I think, you know, most of the times, you know, it varies from, you know, 6 lines or 5 lines to, you know, 30 lines of Docker file.
Yep.
But inside the Docker file, you will actually invoke a shell script. That shell script will actually contain, you know, what logic that you want to do.
Yeah, that's very cool.
That's it.
Right. And if people want to get started and do something like this, they can obviously, because ours are open source, they can obviously just have a look.
They can just see the code and then try to copy. Build it up.
That's fantastic. So that's awesome. I didn't actually realize it was that straightforward. And I also didn't realize that it was our team that was producing these GitHub Actions, which is really good for using whatever language and whatever platform that you...
Right. These are all, correct. Yeah. These are all completely language neutral. You know, if you have, you know, any application that you have, if you are deploying to Azure, you can just, you know, use these to target either AKS or web app for container.
Yeah.
Or if you are in a serverless, you can actually configure functions.
That's pretty awesome. Well, thank you very much for showing us. And yeah, GitHub Actions for CI/CD to Azure. Very cool. Thanks, Gopi.
Thank you, Damian.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you.
All right. We'll join us next time for another DevOps Lab.